Welcome back. We managed to take out this Axopar 25 Spider, which is truly fantastic for us, because this is a pre-production model, which has only been shown to the European press mainly last Tuesday here at the show in Cannes, the south of France. And this is to try and see how everybody likes this pre-production Axopar 25 Spider. It will only be introduced officially in January 2022 at the Düsseldorf Boat Show. So we're really thrilled to be able to take this boat out, especially in a beautiful area like this Cannes area in the south of France. And I must say, I really love driving this boat here. I think the ride is just fantastic. But let me take you through the boat, starting at the bow, like we're used to. This is a cabin boat. So there's a step going up here. There's non-skid here all over the place. And there's an anchor locker here. And I've been informed that there will be an option to have an anchor winch here in the bow locker. It is quite big, so if you don't choose to have an anchor winch here, this is quite a nice storage place also. We put a loose anchor and the line here just now. But this is actually quite a big area, also easy to get on and off the boat if you tend to dock the boat with the bow first. Nice railings, which are higher than on the Axopar 25 Spider. So a good grab on. And of course this sun lounge is also quite nice. Let me also show you how big it is. This actually is a perfect place to sit here and enjoy the sun. To my personal taste, I must say that I find this backrest a bit low, but we always say a boat is never perfect. There's always a compromise somewhere, because if Axopar would have made this higher, it might have blocked the side of the captain and its passenger. So this is a bit of a compromise, and I think what everybody will be doing in practice is that they put some cushions here, maybe even a fat boy, which you can use for multiple purposes. And if this windscreen is tilted up slightly, that gives, I think, a good way of putting cushions here and sitting here quite comfortably. You may not notice now, but this is open because of this tinted window here, giving daylight in the cabin, which is quite a practical solution. But this again is a great place to sit, especially on a day like today, to look out on the water. Cup holders on each side of the sunbend. You have things to hang on to if you are driving. I wouldn't sit here going really fast, but still anchoring, driving slowly, this is just a great place to sit. The drainage has been looked at, of course, so the water would run down. There's a small gunnel here where the water would flow down, so it's quite an easy boat also if you would want to clean it. I like the side rails powder coated in black. I've been informed that Axopar is considering, or at least Brabus is, making a true Brabus 25 Spider. I don't know if they'll have a Brabus line also, I'm not sure about that, but I still like the powder coated railings like we have here. Also the T-top version, which we brought with us, the T-top has been powder coated as well. You may not notice, but there's deck lights here on the sides. There's deck lights also in the cockpit. So there's some really nice details. Non-skid here on the sides also, so if you're more to the side, this is a good place to step on and off the boat. Stainless steel cleats with the Axopar logo engraved. Of course, the stainless steel is still of the 316 quality, which is the best quality available in the marine industry. So yeah, a really lovely bow area. So of course, the purpose of this boat is having a 25 footer with a cabin. But that gives another way of using this boat by having this fantastic sun lounge, which I think a lot of people will appreciate. Let me take you further down the cockpit. This windscreen here can be tilted up. I won't do it now because it's actually better to do it with when you're with two people, but there are screws on each side, so you unscrew them and you take this up so that you are sheltered better from the sun. Me being quite tall, this would actually work quite well for me. But yeah, if you would want it in a bit more sporty mode, you put it down in the position that it is in at this moment. Of course, a good helm position. What I really like and which I what I am impressed with is that the ergonomics on the pre-production boat are already really good. I am more or less leaning, standing here with this flip-up seat, and I feel so protected. This is a really good way of boating, especially going fast, because you push yourself into the seat so that you're locked in a way, protecting yourself from falling overboard. This is comfortable, but if I put this down, it's also fine, especially since I can slide the seat back. Again, myself being quite tall, this is actually really good. Controls of the engines are exactly at the right spot. Steering wheel, I mean, you see my arms being angled slightly. This is just perfect. And this, I should say, is achieved also since Axopar does nearly everything they develop by using virtual reality. I've seen it myself. This is really impressive. I think they're one of the very first boat builders, especially in this range of boats, using virtual reality in a high degree. So you'll notice if I go inside, also there the ergonomics are just perfect. And I must compliment Axopar on achieving that, because I've had some experience with other boat brands where they did pre-production boats, where there's always things which are not on the right position. And I think here, already on this boat, 95% or more is right on the spot. A grab rail here, you see that this is just feels natural. You grab on here. There's an extra cleat here, by the way. I think that this will be an option. The T-top, again, powder coated in black. Another thing I should mention is that there's fabric here, giving the shelter from the sun. And Axopar is looking at, more than looking at, making a solution to open up the T-top, which for Holland is especially nice, because in Holland we're actually really happy when we finally get to feel the sun on our head, so we don't want a T-top such as this. But now that they will be offering the possibility to open it up, as far as I understand, this will be done by using a zipper and also sail buttons that you can just roll it down up to, I think it nearly opens 90% or so, and you have a roll which you tie down, which makes it really simple, efficient, so that it doesn't add to the cost of the boat. With the aim of Axopar still being offering lots of value for money. So this again is a really practical yet low cost solution, which I think will work out just fine. A really nice helm. They installed the 12-inch Shimrad screen here. This looks a bit wide to my personal taste, but I think Axopar is looking into that. The side is open. It's actually quite a big place. You could even mount two 12-inch screens. And this boat is fitted with quite a few extras, like the trim tabs, like the JL Audio, which is new. And I think they're considering using JL Audio for the rest of the range in the future also. And what I am truly happy with is that they decided to install a bow thruster also. Some people may think you don't need that on a 25-footer. Well, I think, especially in a place such as Holland, where we have really tiny marinas, you go into nice places such as Amsterdam or Leiden, which are really not so easy to get around in. In tight spaces, it's really nice to be able to use a bow thruster. And also when you have a strong side wind, even though you're a very experienced captain, this just gives a lot of peace of mind. So a nice option, which I would certainly recommend installing. And I have heard that they're carrying this through on the Axopar 22 Spider even, which is great news. Again, some people may think 22 bow thruster, well, I think it really is a good thing to do. The nice stainless steel switches with the light in, cup holders, Again, really good ergonomics. There's a pocket here to store some small items. Just great, a really wide windscreen, which gives lots of shelter for not only the captain, but also its passengers, I should say, because of course there will be people behind me. So a truly great place. There are two speakers here, by the way, in the subwoofer. This will probably be the audio upgrade, which will be available. So really nice place, ergonomics, perfect. Grab rails here, there's one here to get in and out of the cabin. Let me take you into the cabin while we mention that. Because this, of course, supplements the range of Axopar, with the 22 being a true open boat / bow rider. This boat offers the possibility to stay overnight and make it kind of, what we say, a weekender. This actually is quite a lengthy bed. Let me show you how big it is. Again, I'm 1.93 meters. With my feet right there, you can see that I still have some place. So this is probably 2 meters, which is just perfect. This is actually quite wide also. This feels like I could easily sleep here a couple of nights, no problem. There's a hatch here, which also will take care of ventilation. There are some pockets here, so you can store items. And there's a toilet there, which of course is really useful. And what I think they have used, yes, this is the electric version also, which is actually quite good on a 25-foot boat. There's a small sink here to wash your hands, to rinse some cups, etc. But also here, the ergonomics just feel perfect. And I truly am impressed. They build a boat. I've never been truly involved right from the start, but I can imagine that it starts with an ID, people making sketches, etc. But imagine having to think about an area such as this. Again, I'm 1.93 meters. I can sit here, as you can see. This has been done in such a way that this is useful. I mean, if you get out of bed, you want to take your clothes on, there's still, even for a tall guy like me, there's enough space. Of course, it's not a 30-footer, but still works just fine. Daylight here, and this is all accomplished by doing the virtual reality, where you actually more or less enter the boat in a digital way. You can walk around, so you can see how far the distances are, how it feels, how airy it is, etc. And they really managed to do this. And they use the space under the deck here to add some space here. So a truly great cabin. The step in and out of the boat, of the cabin, is good. Let me take this down again. There's a cushion, by the way, also here on top of the toilet, so you could also sit here. This is used for steps. I would have liked some storage space below here. I asked about that, but they say it isn't possible because there's a stringer below, which is a bit of it would be better if you could have some storage space, but I imagine that people tend to bring bags or something where you leave your stuff. But still, again, a really nice cabin for 25 footer. There's some lights here, switches for the lights here. I should have taken them on earlier, sorry about that. Now you can actually see it even better. Didn't know we left the main switches on. But again, a truly nice, roomy cabin, which I think is one of the main advantages of this Axopar 25 Spider. There's a small hatch here, by the way, to have access to all kinds of technical items. That is also a thing what I see, or where I notice that the people at Axopar are experienced boat builders. It's not only that the boat looks nice, the ergonomics are fine, but they also gave the maintenance and the long-term usability of the boat through consideration by looking at things to access all the technical items. So there's again a hatch here. This can be opened here, so you have access to tanks, wiring, etc., etc. So well done. Again, grab rail here. The seats, as I mentioned, can you can slide them forward and aft, but they can also be turned. Let me actually try that for a change. This is always a bit of a gamble in the video, I must say. This works out quite well. So, This boat is equipped with the multi-storage. You can also have the U-shape here, which I personally think will be ordered most in the Netherlands and Belgium. But I just wanted to show you this because this actually is a quite nice place to sit. And if you bring friends and if you have the U-sofa, you could really make this a nice social area. If you also turn this seat, you have this U-sofa here. You put the table in between, which will be an option, so that you can actually have a great lunch here, have a drink, play a game of cards, whatever you'd like to do. And then this is truly great. The boat, the beam of the boat is actually the same as on the Axopar 22 Spider, which some people think is quite narrow. I personally feel that the boat is roomier than the width would actually, well, the expectations that the width would give you, but that has been done by having these, the sides of the boat being made in a way that they're not all too chunky, so you have lots of space here. But the main purpose also is that they didn't want to build this boat all too beamy because they want to be able to put it in a container, so that again the cost of transporting it to remote locations is quite low because it can go into an international container. But still, I think this works out really perfect. There's a step here, there's a step there, so you can go on and off the boat from this place if you don't have the T-top. Let me think if there's any other things I should mention. Of course, these are really nice to grab onto. You can use them also to attach your fenders to the boat. The sides are actually even higher than on the 22, giving you lots of shelter, and it makes it really safe, easy. If you bring small kids, they don't tend to fall overboard easily. So really nice sides, good to hang on to. If you tend to do fishing, it's really great to stand here with a fishing rod and in your hands without having the feel of falling overboard easily. So a really great setup. This boat again has the multi-storage. Now this backrest has been put in this position, but it can be turned 90 degrees so that you have it like this and you could lean against it looking over the water or in the other direction. The big advantage of the multi-storage, like the word already says, is that it is a huge storage area. I won't open it because we're on a boat show there, so there's lots of stuff underneath, but a truly practical and great place to store items. Of course, there's cleats here also with the Axopar logo again, a stainless steel flagpole with the Finnish flag. Axopar being a Finnish company, building in Poland, very cost efficient, lots of experience. There are lots of good boat builders in Poland. Coming to the transom and the swimming platform, what they've done really nice is that with this outboard setup, they've made these angled swimming platforms, which are actually quite nice. I also like the aesthetics that the outboard more or less is fitted into the swimming platform. But it's also really practical. As you can see here, I have plenty of place here to walk around. You could sit here with your feet in the water. This optional ski pylon is truly good also to grab onto. There's a small step here. This is something you can hang on to. There's an outside shower here. So if you take a plunge, which you probably will be doing after the video, then you could rinse the salt water by using the outside shower. There's a filler cap here for the water tank. So again, a truly nice setup here right at the aft. The swimming ladder is below this piece here. So good access. You can grab onto the ski pylon if you want to get in or out of the water. And a very important thing, this boat can handle the new V8 Mercuries. And this is, I think, especially good news. It can handle up to 250 horsepower. And the good thing with these V8s is that they have the advanced midsection. giving it a truly smooth ride, really low vibration, really good fuel economy, yet a powerful engine because it has a really good torque, so it jumps out of the water, we've just noticed. Of course it will perform perfectly also with the V6 or maybe even lower, but I personally think choosing a V8 behind this 25 Spider would be the choice that most people probably make, I think. So really great. Let me in the meantime tell you something about the hull. So let's jump over to the stand and let's explain something about the hull of this Oxapar 25 Spider T-top in this particular case. Let me tell you about the hull of this Oxapar 25 Spider. Everybody knows, I think, in the meantime, that Oxapar is using a stepped hull. And most people think that a stepped hull is done mainly to have to achieve a high top speed. That actually is not the main reason. The most important reason is creating stability. And why am I saying that? Usually a planing boat gets its stability on the place where the water pushes against the hull from the underwater side, the strongest, which is on the aft of the boat. If you have steps like you have here, there's one here which goes from one side completely to the other side, and there's a second one right there, you create extra places where the water is pushing against the hull. So if you do the boating on an Oxapar with a stepped hull, and if you're planing, if you walk around the boat, please check that yourself. If you have the opportunity to make a test drive at the dealer, you'll notice that the boat is extremely stable. Not only that, if you go up to plane and further, you will generate what we call air pockets, because there's some air caught in here, so that the friction of the hull and the water is reduced, because the friction with air is less than the friction with water, making it a very efficient hull, decreasing the fuel consumption and increasing the top speed. So that is what I'd like to say about the steps. This being the Oxapar 25 Spider, a really good story is that this is a special hull. And why is it special? That is because it's not made in the way that 99% maybe, I don't know, of the boats are made from a mold. And they usually use for the hull a single piece mold. Why is that important? Oxapar is using a three-piece mold. And why are they doing that? Well, the main reason is to get the biggest beam right at the end of the boat, which is right here. So the tallest beam is right at the end. And that gives this boat its extreme stability. But not only that, Oxapar managed to still not make the boat too wide, so it can actually get into a container, making it easier, thus cheaper to transport it to all kinds of places over the world. Not only that, because they have this three-piece mold, you also create the possibility to have a really nice and smooth surface. Most boats, again, are made from a single-piece mold. You have a hull, they put the deck on, and the place where both of them are attached usually is a ugly line, which is covered by something like a rub rail. You'll notice that there's no rub rail on this boat, and that is also because of this three-piece mold. So it's a really nice and smooth surface. Not only that, it's extremely strong, and Oxapar emphasized or increased the rigidity and the strength of the hull by making what we say a sculpted hull. You'll see all these things, not making it a straight and simple hull, but this is sculpted, this is sculpted. Of course, this is also done to give it really good aesthetics. The boat, I think, really looks great. But not only that, it just makes the boat a lot stronger. The rub rail, by the way, will be an option, so you can add it later on. Could be interesting if you transport it first and add the rub rail later on. So a truly fantastic hull. Now this is a boat, the first bigger sister of the 22, which is a fantastic boat, which has been on the market since this year, 2021. But there's a cabin, so of course there's an elevated deck. But a good thing is also, if you look at the profile of the boat, is that the hull is relatively high, making it, giving it an even drier ride. And you'll notice also that the bow tends to lean down, I would say. And why is that done? Again, of course, it's aesthetics, it's the look, it's the profile, it's the design of the boat. But not only that, there's an important practical reason about it, because if you take the boat up the plane, even though any Axopar is relatively neutral taking it up to plane, most boats which you take up to plane will do this. And of course an Axopar does the same. Not all too much, very little actually, but it still does it in a certain percentage, so the bow is raised. And in many boats, the bow is taking away the sight, the visibility of the captain and its passengers. And by having this bow area more or less leaning down, you create extra visibility. So, a really fantastic hull. And what they've done also is that they created the possibility to have a bow thruster. Some people don't believe in bow thrusters, but I do. I just personally think that it makes boating a lot easier. Even though you might be a very experienced boater like myself, I've been boating over 30 years now, it's always good to be able to take a boat back in a dock, going with the stern first, with a force 5 from the side, and then it's just so easy and gives the captain confidence to easily take the boat in without making any damage. So that is going to be an option on the 25 Spider. The 22, which is right here, on that boat it will also be an option for at least sometime 2022, I've been told. So that's about the hull. Back to boating. So we're off with this Axopar 25 Spider with a 250 V8 again. Engine is running, we're taking the boat out. We're driving 5 knots at the moment, so actually quite slow. This already is quite nice, with the advantage of a boat outboard powered, that it doesn't go like this. Boats which have a stern drive tend to do this. Not on this Axopar 25 Spider, because it has an outboard. So a lot of people will appreciate that, especially in the Netherlands with all the narrow waters where you cannot go fast. Taking this boat out, I think the combination again with the V8 is really great. It doesn't mean that you always have to go fast. Going low RPM like we're doing now, 1400, is actually quite nice already. Boat running smooth, really low vibration, this really works perfect. But then again, it is a sporty boat, it's truly fast. So we're picking up the speed, the engine's still warm. I have to do this slowly again for the cameraman. But if I were to press the throttle right away, we would jump out of the water. I'll do it gently this time. Taking her up to plane, 15 knots, 20 knots. Let me take the speed down just a bit. 21 knots, this is quite a nice speed. And this is comfortable, we cruise quite a long distance, still manage to peak. You can see I don't use my hands, boat feels really stable, just going straight, no problem whatsoever. Let me take some relatively slow yet short turns. Perfect. Let me take our own waves. It's a bit bumpy here at the moment, a bit of a swell. Still, it's a really dry ride, really smooth and truly short turns, no problem. Steering is power assisted, hydraulically, yet There's an electric power steering, making it possible to steer with just a finger, like I'm doing at the moment. Doing 30 knots, and we just have the boat get a stable speed, also because there's a special system on these Mercuries, where if you drive, I don't know how long, I think 1 or 2 minutes, they optimize the fuel oxygen ratio. So the fuel consumption, you can actually see that if you take the time, is reduced by, I don't know, 10% or so. And of course, this is a boat which is powered with a 250 horsepower that we turn around and try to find some flat water. There's lots of waves here. Been quite a few boats around and some swell. Active trim is on. 40 knots. Truly good speed. What I intend to say with this fuel economy, of course you see it going up if you go faster, but there's a really good and wide range with a good fuel economy, which is really nice. So depending on the conditions, if you have conditions like we have now with some swell, you cannot really go fast, but still the fuel economy is good. If there's flat water, you go faster, you don't have to worry that the fuel economy gets lots worse. It really works out quite well, like we're used to with any Axopar. So a truly sporty, but still very, I feel, reliable boat. I mean, it handles perfectly. We just got a bit of a spray, but we didn't have that before. But we got some huge waves. But a truly nice combination with this V8 outboard. Now the engine is running at idle. It feels like the engine is off. I really am, anytime this happens, I'm impressed with the smoothness and the character of this fantastic V8 engine. So this is the preview of the Axopar 25 Spider. I hope you like it. I think Axopar will also be interested if you do have remarks, because they're still developing things, they're still changing things, they're still looking at ways to improve it even further. Perfect can always be done better, something that I tend to hear every now and then. But I really like it like it is at the moment. But please look at the video in detail and let us know if you have some remarks. For now, I'd like to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again in one of our next videos.